Good morning, it's 1:51 a.m. December 29, 2017. I haven't made a video in a while. And I think I've given enough information to help you people figure out what has really happened here. I'm actually very tired of being here. I know that I am trapped in some type of simulation where this is someone else's projected hell reality. And I'm trapped, parts of my ethereal and subtle body is trapped in a very advanced technology where, like I said before, They chipped me here, they damaged the middle of my spine there, and then something happened where they injected me. I think they were trying to inject me with nanobites or nanoprobes, which has messed everything up. Okay? I know that I don't just exist here. I'm existing other places. In another world. And I've seen my Vedic ancient family around my bed because of what's been done here. This isn't the reality, people. This is the Mandela effect. I've also been told that there have been 9 or 10 Earths previous before this Earth. So, in my previous videos, I discussed how this technology, this ancient technology, can manipulate the weather, it can manipulate the animals, it can destroy planetary systems. And from what I was told, this is a prison planet and a dumping planet. They dump people here. But I didn't get dumped here. I came here to oversee these fallen beings that were over this little realm in a meeting with them. And they decided that they had already had it planned out. If I didn't go along with the program that they were going to have on this planet, that they were going to seize me and have me hostage here. And that happened a long, long time ago. They're afraid of the Shakti power. Nobody has any rights trying to destroy what someone is from the beginning of their way. I told you people, the only way you're going to escape here is chanting the Maha Mantra. And at the time of your death, I said, Hail Mary, Mother full of grace, have mercy upon thee at the hour of our death. But I did tell y'all my boat got exploded. My doves and everything. Now I'm telling you, chant the Maha Mantra. Chant the Hare Krishna Mantra at the hour or the time that you think that something is getting ready to happen really bad so that your soul can be transcended out of here. Because the whole idea now is for them to have a war. I tried to prevent that, and I'm being thought of as the terrorist. Their whole idea is to have a nuke war, because they're no longer welcome in the cosmos, or to explode this planet into a sun. They never had any intentions for you people to come from underneath this. Y'all were going to be a food source and an energy source for them. And I have taken enough damage now to where when they unravel some more of this, I can get back into myself, because right now I feel like my whole brain, like that woman on Metropolis movie, like they got something on my brain constantly where I can't meditate or be into my creative endeavors of creative writing. They have triangulated on this area. And there's an opening where they think they're going to get into paradise. And parts of my energetic body is over that. And it's probably, I don't know what part it is, but they're going through it. And it feels like they're going through my private part. Understand me? They're entering paradise through my vagina. Or my huge body that's not like this little body. I also told you that when you see the Hindu deities and you see them with 4 arms, 6 arms, 9, 10 arms, that's because of the abilities they've earned in the cosmos, the things they have control over. This body that you're in is not your only body. There's bodies within your body. And these adept beings that know how to manipulate the bodies and suck and take other people's subtle bodies and put them in jars or put them, house them in different, they know what they did, they've done to me. It's not only sacrilegious, it's unheard of and it's horrible. I have a right not to want to birth children that are golems, the demons down here. Understand me? Me and Sri Krishna are on the same page. I've been denied entrance into India. I've been denied a passport to leave here. I don't want to be here in this country. I don't want to work for the United States government. I never put in to be a Nazi experiment or part of the US DOD or the CIA. This is a cosmic crime. And I need to be able to meditate deeply. Because I'm not even having mercy on devas or any of the dyads or devas or asuras. Anything from the Vedic pantheon right now is getting ready to have to answer to. There's uncharted territory. There's beings that I know out there for a long, long time that have nothing to do with religions. Yet they know how to live in peace and unity and harmony and love. And this was a very, very unloving act. To attack an Amsa Vishnu, one of his longtime eternal devotees, and my bhakti yoga, which is my expression for the love of Godhead, has been messed with badly. I can't tolerate it anymore. All of those AIs are getting ready to be taken down. CERN is getting ready to be exposed to large hadron colliders everywhere. And even the mirror machine. This gig is over with. They have exhausted my patience, taken advantage of my kindness. I've already explained to you people the way they want to go with this. They wanted a root race that would be able to adapt to this terraformed environment, which would be half machine, half human. My body doesn't agree with that. Not this physically. I'll never agree to transhumanism. Never supposed to be trying to make me into a radio head and shoot all these frequencies and attach all this crap to me. This planetarium is out. This is not about the soul of humanity. Humanity will always exist. Humanity exists out there. This is a power play here. Against someone who has authority. Very powerful. To do something about this. And they decide to use technology to prevent that person or being from doing their work. Because they're envious and hateful and jealous of my relationship with the actual creator. And if he goes along with it, I guess I will become the salt in the fresh water again. All the Sumerian deities and the Egyptian deities are gone. They have to be eliminated. There's no ifs, ands, and buts about it. That's the end of it for the Sumerian deities and the Egyptian deities. And there will be no Tibetan kings ruling here. You tell them that. Because that's another aspect of this that y'all don't know about. The Tibetan kings and priest class will not rule here anymore. Have a good morning, baby.